Hey, as I'm getting over this cold, I'm like a day or two away. NBA 2K decided to bless us with all kinds of news, man. It was like a bombardment, a flurry of news from both the current gen version and the next gen version of NBA 2K21. So let's get into it, man. But before we do, if y'all new to the channel, you haven't already, be sure to subscribe. Yeah, do that. Hey, that's all. That's all I want y'all to do. And drop a like if you're feeling real good about yourselves. Hey, it has been difficult to get up and do work-related things the last couple days. When I'm sick, energy just depletes. It's nowhere to be found. But I'm slowly getting it back, so that feels great. Hey, let's get into this beautiful, juicy news. Let's start off with all the NBA 2K21 news. And 2K usually releases information in exciting ways, but this year, they wanted to bore us. Because they know I'm going to read a blog report, a blog post, but they know y'all not gonna read a blog post. Mike Wang, what is happening right now? Why are we releasing exciting gameplay news in the most boring format imaginable? Stop it. It's time for me to break down everything that was said in this incredibly long blog post. First things first is there is a new shot meter. If you're wondering what the new shot meter looks like, it looks like this.
Roll the clip.
The few changes that were made to the shot meter, because you must be thinking the same thing I thought before I read the blog post, that's the same thing. It kind of is. They changed the color of the shot meter so that it shows more depending on the court you're playing on. Sometimes it was hard to see the shot meter. They added this small little green arrow to help the casual people know exactly when to release the ball. But aside from that, yeah, it's basically the same shot meter. There was more changes made to the complexity in which you have to release the ball this year, because we know there's shot timing, there's shot aiming, but now there's a new factor 2K is looking to include in the next gen version of the game, and that's your shot arc. They dropped a video here to kind of illustrate what they mean, but they said because of the new next gen technologies, you're gonna be able to control the arc at which you shoot the basketball. So on the left-hand side, Stephen Curry's taking a very narrow shot. On the right-hand side, high arc. And I mean, I kind of like the idea of this as long as it doesn't become something that throws off the balance of the game. You feel me? You add more controls, you increase the skills gap. I see what they're trying to do. Let me just play the video though, so y'all see what they see. All right, so you can do that now too. They said, and I quote, "For next gen, the stick speed also controls now the arc of your jump shot. Slow flicks give an extra high arc, while fast flicks give yourself a flat shot," in case you wondered how that works. That's actually something they mentioned a couple times in the blog post. They could use the speed at which you flick the stick as an input, as like a control in the game, so it means something. That's not something they were able to do in previous generations, and that actually applies elsewhere. But where, Agent, where does that apply? Well, let me get to it, guys. It's a long blog post, okay? Dribbling. That's where it applies. Next gen has given us the opportunity to add an interesting feature to ball handling that we never had before. The ability to control the speed at which your size up moves based on how slowly or quickly you flick the pro stick. So if you're a dribble head, you're gonna wanna be clickety clacking. You can be running through controllers one time a month. I know PlayStation and Xbox, they made this move strategically because they know their margins are in the accessories that you buy. So the more controllers you buy, the more money they make. They don't make that much. They actually lose money when you buy consoles. So they need you to buy more controllers. They want you to run through them. It's quick. And you're gonna run through them quick dribbling in NBA 2K21 next gen, all right? It is kind of cool outside of playing around that you can now use that as an input. That's dope. So you can kind of move slow on your size up and then explode this way. In theory, that's dope. I want to see how it plays in practice though. They also mentioned they added LeBron James and James Harden's signature moves. And now there's two different types of moving shots. In the past, it kind of all fell under the same umbrella, but now they separated it. There's controlled and high momentum moving shots. They said the controlled ones you use, it's a regular moving shot, but when you're not sprinting and you get a certain type of animation. And the high momentum ones are when you're coming off of a sprint. When you're coming off of a sprint, it's harder to make the shot, but it's obviously easier to create more space. So it's a give and take there. I like it. In practice, I don't know how it's gonna apply, but in theory, sounds cool to me. And they added some signature packages, some more animations to use. We're all good with that. Okay, this next thing is something that players have been asking for in current gen. For whatever reason, it's continued to get worse, but Mike Wang clarified on Twitter. He said this applies to today's current gen patch also. So if you want to unequip park handles completely, keep tight handles at gold or lower. And he linked to the bit in the patch notes where it illustrates as such. Park handles is still L3, but you can now remove it by just not having Hall of Fame tight handles, I guess. Interesting fix. I feel like it would have been just better to just turn it off as a whole, like a toggle for the people who don't want it, but I guess this is the way they decided to go. That's something that Badge Plug brought up in the replies. He said to Mike Wang, "Mike, please make sure if Next Gen has park handles, there is an on-off setting in the animations, just like for park layups and dunks." Things got pretty more interesting because apparently 2K released some stuff that they weren't supposed to release in the video trailer that dropped a couple days ago. I actually dropped a video reacting to it on my second channel, so if you missed it, subscribe to my second channel. I keep trying to tell y'all, man. Ronnie2K said this on Twitter, "So much for hiding James Harden, as the video was planned a day later in the first of three courtside reports, people realizing this was a Mavs Warriors post." Because if you remember in the trailer, there was like a couple random clips, and then there was a Mavs Warriors game. Kind of just felt random to have those other clips there. Apparently, it wasn't even supposed to be there, it was a mistake, but one of the clips we got from that mistake was this James Harden step back that actually looks really clean. And then he pulls up for the shot. All of that looks juicy and clean to me personally. But we got even more information just based off of this tweet, because that means that this blog post we got was one of three. And at the very bottom of the blog post, if we scroll all the way down, Mike Wang says, "That about covers it for this week, but don't worry, we're just getting started. Stay tuned for the next courtside report where we'll talk about the great tech that we built for 2K21 next gen gameplay." So this is part one of three, I guess, a series they're doing to kind of release information. I'm curious why they're deciding to do it in the form of blog posts they know people aren't gonna read. But let's continue, because there's more stuff that was mentioned in the blog post, some changes made to the next gen version of the game. Okay, so this part really interested me because they tried this in the past with 2K17 and they found it to be incredibly overpowered and they took it away, and it's 3-point line recognition. They say, "In the past, you'd either slide back for the 3-point shot, which looked pretty bad, or step on the line for a long two, but now we adjust your feet placement in real time when you're near the line to ensure that no longer happens." If you guys remember in 2K17, this happened across the board, but especially in the corners where they had this cute little stutter step animation, so you wouldn't get long twos. Like, it was actually hard to get long twos in the corner on 2K17, because the animation would always pull you straight into the corner, which is kind of what you wanted anyway. Nobody really wants that long two. But that animation was so strong that it would trigger when you're at the hash. And I guess 2K thought it was too overpowered. They removed it from the game a few patches in. And this seems to be the first time since 2K17 that they're trying to reintroduce some point of 3-point line recognition. And I guess they mentioned some new technologies possible because of next-gen systems. So hopefully this is implemented better in a way that doesn't take over your player. But at the same time, allows you to be where you want to be on the floor. That's a problem I'm having right now on current-gen 2K21. It is hard to get to the corner without stepping out of bounds or taking a long two. I always just opt for the long two because I'm tired of stepping out of bounds trying to force that corner three. It would make off-ball play infinitely more interesting, in my opinion. In terms of animations, 2K added, "There's a host of new moves and first step launches at your disposal, including hesitations, escapes, step backs, hard goes, and crosses," which is exciting to hear. This is good news, because when current gen was being promoted and there were like 40 new jump shot landings, that basically told me that they basically made no effort in trying to include new animations into that game. So my hope was all the animation work that they were doing was gonna be showing off in next gen, so this is good. Across the board, we'd like to see more animations in every single category. That gives us more options, more combos, more things to play with. So this is interesting. They had a whole section for passing. They mentioned how the pass physics has improved dramatically, and without trying to bore you to death, basically it means that things like this right here are now possible. You can throw oops off the backboard. It was possible like in 2005 when we played NBA Street, but now the technology is possible in 2K21 next gen. Okay, so this is probably the most interesting thing for me personally, because I don't know why it wasn't in the game already, but it seems like they're making an effort to put it in the game now, is lead passes. If you guys have ever played FIFA before, you know one of the biggest parts of the game in finding yourself open is doing a through pass, right? And so now in NBA 2K, they give you the ability to throw a lead pass, so you don't throw it directly where your teammate's at, you throw it where you think he's going to go. So if you're on the fast break, you'll throw it forward and he'll catch the ball. If he's coming off an off-ball screen pinned down, you'll throw it where he wants to shoot the ball. And so ideally, it's just a more fluid way to play basketball. This is what they say in the notes. They say in the blog post, "Holding the lead pass button works like the regular pass button now, allowing you to target further away receivers for a skip pass lead to the basket, perfect for long outlet passes to finish the break." It's about time a feature like that was introduced to 2K. They most definitely did not need to wait till next gen to make that happen, but hey, I'm happy it's here now. They had a whole section for layup timing, and it was a lot of what we kind of seen in current gen NBA 2K21. Our engineers spent a lot of time improving layup selection to detect defensive threats and smartly choose the most open spot to lay the ball up. So that means when you're open on the right-hand side of the basket, your player's not gonna do a reverse and try and go on the contested left-hand side of the basket. And they also said that that means the AI are gonna start taking better attempts too when they're attacking the rim. So that means when you're playing the AI on my career or on my team for whatever challenge, you have to be a little bit smarter with the way you play paint defense. They mentioned bank shots are in the game now, and they brought it up as like this new thing. Bank shots have always been in the game. It's something that they recently removed, but if you click towards the basket, that's always been a bank shot on 2K. So I refuse to believe that this is something new. It's interesting though how they're trying to create inputs for everything, give us full control over the way that we attack the basket, the way that we shoot the ball. Now you could aim the arc of your shot, bro. You could aim the actual shot, and then you could also just time your shot. And if you do all three of those beautifully, boom, it's banging. I like that. And I feel like it's gonna make the game a lot more challenging to balance, but in practice, I'll wait, but in theory, that gets me excited. So, I mean, as a person who's gonna read this regardless, it got me excited about next gen, personally. I'm excited to see what the other two out of three is, and if they come with their own trailer. I'm curious why they're releasing the information this way, because I feel like it's not the most palatable. Most people are just gonna wait to watch a video like this, or to go on Twitter and see what people clip and post. Because that's kind of what happened. The first I heard about the shot meter was from Toasted's post saying what the shot meter looks like on next gen. So most people aren't even gonna bother to pay attention to that whole post. But that's for the next gen version. They also just released a new patch on the current gen version of the game, and there's some changes made there. Quick little intermission to ask you guys to subscribe to the channel. You know what I'm saying? You don't have to though, you feel me, if you don't want to. But why wouldn't you want to though? Okay, so patch update 3 is live, Halloween themed neighborhood. So now there's some, well, it's self-explanatory. There's some gameplay adjustments they boast about and improvements across every game mode. Oh, you're spoiling us today, 2K. That's highly likely to be capped, but let's keep moving forward. In the actual patch notes, let me summarize them for you because of course you don't like to read. Well, the Halloween has come to the 2K beach. So there's that. And more importantly, especially for the people that plan on playing more of the current gen version of the game, preparations for the new 2K beach events coming later in October and November. So they're gonna have a steady dose of events even when the next gen game comes out. It's expected, but it's good they're not gonna just abandon the game when the next gen one comes out. That's good. In terms of gameplay, they made some changes to the way you set screens so it's more realistic. Interestingly enough, in the notes, they say they tried to change shot aiming system to prevent the modded controller abuse, but people tried it, and apparently you can still do the modded controller in the game, so that has not been patched even though it's in the patch notes. I have no idea why it's in here. And as Mike Wang mentioned earlier, you can now remove your park handles by just dropping tight handle badge to gold or lower. Aside from that, the only other interesting bit of news was they're preparing for the 250K My Team tournament. So that's been confirmed now. If you guys participate in that yearly thing they do now, chance to win $250,000. But that's really not where the news ended, because there's been some more kind of drama going on behind the scenes. And I'm gonna follow up because Agent Beamstar was letting y'all know in the last 2K drama alert the action that was going down between the game and pool. So I guess the game has been continuing to get flack for boosting to be the top rep on NBA 2K21 current gen. And this is what he decided to post on Twitter. He's been kind of taking it as a joke. He's been trolling, but this is what he said. Folks really out here trying to make snitching cool. Wake up to Master Splinter in the mirror every day and live a normal life. But he decided to follow up because he posted on Twitter saying NBA 2K21 next gen gameplay. So someone replied to the game and said, "You gonna boost here too?" And the game said, and I quote, "When Ronnie sleep." Oh my God, it's beautiful. I like how he was just having fun with it. And then things get even funnier because the game, and I quote, not only changed his gamer tag on Xbox to Free Pool, but on top of that, here's a screenshot he posted on Twitter of him beating Badge Plug in a game. Oh, you can't make this stuff up, man. You cannot make this stuff up. So apparently the game is really bad as business, man. Yeah, I'm not gonna lie to y'all. Back in like years ago, someone told me the game was like top 10 on the Madden leaderboards. And you know what I'm saying? When I heard about all this 2K boosts and stuff, I was like, maybe he just boosted to get there. Maybe he's just a real gamer, man. We don't know. Hey, the game, this is a challenge to you. I haven't been playing the game last few weeks, so it shouldn't be very difficult for you. But I won't play the game in a game, man. That'd be tough, no cap. That was like the time DeAndre Ayton was just dropping off YouTubers left and right for no reason. Batchbug responded to him though, and he said, "Bruh, you ain't beat me. I had your guard on clamps, but GG." Nade responded saying, "Dude's out here losing to the game." 2K community is beautiful, man. You gotta love it. That's been it for the news. Yo, listen, man, if y'all wanna stay in the loop, y'all know what to do. Subscribe to the channel, man. Turn on the bell. Second channel link in the description. I dropped my reaction to the gameplay trailer. I'll leave that as an end screen right here too, but link in the description, man. I'm gonna catch you guys in the next one. I'm out. Peace.